Hey everybody, how's it going? Check it out. Upon successful completion of this video, I'm going to show you one of the best accessories you can get for your Mr. Heater Portable Buddy. Okay, so if you're not familiar with what I'm talking about, this is what I'm talking about. This is the Portable Buddy Heater by Mr. Heater. And actually what it does is it takes that little propane canister and heats up that white ceramic square in there and puts out a nice gentle heat. And these things can be used in small spaces like tents and things like that. And they've got a lot of popularity now with van dwellers, and van dwellers have been using these things for a long time. We've had this one for, 6 years now. And a little secret, the best time to buy these is in the summertime when nobody cares about being cold, and you can get them for like 60 bucks or so. But anyway, this is what you get when you buy it. You don't even get the green thing. You don't get the propane cylinder. You just get the heater, and that's it. It's in the box, and there you go. Now, it doesn't really require much, but one of the best accessories you can get, I think, is this. This is a Portable Buddy gear bag. Portable carry bag, off-season storage and protection, bunch of French, blah, 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 some more French, blah, 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 blah. What this actually does for you is it takes this and puts it inside the bag, and the bag itself will hold two propane canisters, as you see on the side there, but more importantly, it keeps it safe for storage, keeps the dust off of it, because if you'll take a little look here, even being stored in a clean environment, you still get dust and possibly spiders. So here we go. Here's what you get. This is designed to fit all 9 Bravo or 9 Bravo X-Ray Mr. Heater Buddy Heaters. That's pretty much, for the most part, all of them, especially with the older style. The part number, if you're looking for something like this, is Foxtrot 232149. You can buy these all over the place. Sometimes you'll see them on sale. You can get on Amazon. They're pretty readily available. So, zipper storage compartment. Store some extra propane greenies. Has a little handle carry strap right there. Tuck up handle so you can kind of carry it around. And let's see how thick and wonderful and durable this thing will or will not be. Snazzy red stripe. Folded pretty tight. Okay, so right out of the box, we actually have some pretty thick either Cordova or some kind of canvas type material. It's like a thick backpack. Got the Mr. Heater logo on there. It's kind of painted on, maybe a little screen printing process. The zippers don't have anything on them. They're not YKK. Feels like a nylon zipper. Made in China. And as I'm sure you're well aware, you don't store these heaters with the propane canisters attached if you're going to store the heater inside. As a matter of fact, it's probably recommended that you store the canisters away from the heater. They even recommend in some cases to store the propane canisters outside. So let's go ahead and we're going to take this off. The anticipation. Usually when they're full, they do a pshht, scares me every time. Alright, so there we go. Heater fits nicely. Plenty of room, even with the handle up. Should zip over just fine so I can see where they say the company basically allow you to accommodate different types of the heaters that Mr. Heater makes. Very thick. I feel like the seams are nice. I don't feel like it's going to rip through the bottom. I feel like the zipper is probably going to hold up since there's enough slack that it shouldn't necessarily be an issue. Yeah, pretty good. Boxed in, sewn there with a little X across the center. These look slightly flimsy, but the material feels thick. So here's the funny thing about this bag, right? Is it kind of looks like it should be cheap, but everything is thick and durable. Nice. Nice. So we have here a couple canisters. Let's see if we can put them in the holders. Okay, I like the way the actual pouch goes in here, or the pouch actually holds the greenie, the little 1 pound propane canister. Check it out, it takes it to just above the shoulder of the canister so that it won't sling out. It's in there pretty good. I like that. Let me go ahead and load the other side with this remaining bottle right here. Two canisters loaded right there. Nice racing stripe, makes it slightly more sporty. Got the handles. Looks pretty much the same as this, except they have the carry handle sticking out. You don't necessarily need that because you do have handles to carry it. So if you're one of those people that likes to get all the bags out of the back of the car using all your fingers and the thumb. Does have a shoulder strap which you can adjust. I think it's pretty durable. Actually, I feel pretty good with this thing. And for those of you who don't know, I've done lots of camera bag and messenger bag reviews in the past, so I kind of like bags for whatever reason, backpacks included. So with this particular bag, I actually feel pretty good about it. The material's nice and thick, the stitches and around all the seams are good. Didn't see any weirdness going on with the zipper or anything like that. Everything appears to be put in its proper place. It doesn't look out of alignment or any kind of strangeness like that. I do have a criticism, though. I do believe on the carry handles, where you can pull them both up and carry them like a purse or a bowling ball bag or something like that, it does need some Velcro. A nice little bit of Velcro with a closure to be able to make a better handle out of it would be super cool. Also, with the shoulder strap, it should have a pad to make it a lot easier to carry, because this thing's not too heavy, but you add the propane canisters, and you add the overall weight of the heater, and maybe if you're walking from the parking lot to wherever you're going, like a campsite or maybe a day picnic area or somewhere like that where you need to keep some, it's going to weigh a lot. So it may weigh a little bit now, but it'll weigh a whole lot more later. So adding those two or three comfort things to it, as far as maybe some additional padding and being able to secure the handle and take those two loops and make one strong handle would be a lot better. Overall, I think this is one of the best accessories you can get for your heater, for your portable buddy. Because it's going to keep the dust off, it's going to keep it secure, it's going to keep scratches off of it, it's going to keep liquids off of it, it's going to keep weird stuff off of it. You're going to be able to take it and put it away somewhere and keep it relatively clean the way it is. If you're going to use this bag and something like that, so when you're done with the heater, for example, you should make sure it's completely cool before you put it in the bag, because you don't want to set yourself on fire or the bag or whatever else. But yeah, it's a good bag. I like it. I think it's worth the cost. And being able to take this and secure it, and also include maybe those two greenies, those 2 1-pound greenies there, so I'll be able to take the heater, store it with 2 pounds of propane relatively safely, where it's not going to spark because of the material that it's in, nice and secure, and being able to put it away, like in the back of your car or your van or whatever, and ride down the road, and not have it tip over, not have it fall over, not have it spark or hit up against something, that sort of thing, is the peace of mind is going to be pretty good. Are there other bags available? Sure. Do they have that snazzy red racing stripe on them? Does it say Mr. Heater? Is it kind of designed for this in a way that sort of has the durability and the structural integrity to it to hold that product with those 2 pound cylinders? I don't know. You could probably stuff this in a backpack. This bag's made for it, and I think at the end of the day, for long-term storage or even traveling storage, this is going to be the way to go. So here's the deal. I got a link to all this on Amazon if you want to take a look at it. I've had this heater for a long time, and I've always had to kind of be safe and put it in a place where it wouldn't get all dinged up when we had it in our previous van. And I finally decided to break down and spend a little bit of money and get this bag for it. Glad I did, because I'm going to take it, I'm going to put it in the back underneath the bed where we have a lot of garage storage space, and tuck it away. And I can ride with it all year long and not worry about it. Plus, if you don't have any spiders in the heater, if you have it nice and zipped up, you'll keep the spiders away. So there you go. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, let me know. Oh, I almost forgot. Last video I said I was going to start including some of the funny comments that I receive off some of my 700 videos that I've done over the years. This one is someone that I see a lot, and it basically has to do with my introduction song on some of my videos. And by some, I mean about 500 of them. So it's called the Peanut Butter Song. I made a long time ago. I bought some, long story short, I actually bought a solar dancing flower. It was a little flower, a little plastic toy that you get from the Dollar Tree of all places. A little tiny little solar panel on it, and these flowers would dance. And one was dancing on my porch one day, and I came up with the Peanut Butter Song, and I decided to go ahead and use that as a quirky way for people to remember my videos. Here's the deal. Some people love it. Some people hate it. It was even remixed one time. One of my students, actually, for my birthday, remixed that song and made it longer, so if I wanted to submit it to iTunes, I could. And I haven't done it. I've had requests from people to make have me make that that MP3 available to them so they could use it as a ringtone. Fun fact, my daughter was in high school a long time ago, and she said she was going through the halls and she actually heard a couple students singing that peanut butter song because evidently somebody had found that I made videos, and so, yeah. So people love it, people hate it, but at the end of the day, I like it, so I include it when I feel I want to. Some people said my videos would be better without it, and to those people I say, maybe, maybe not, but so, there you go. I've probably been playing the peanut butter song the whole time for this little part right here, but so it is what it is. So, anyway, see you later. Take it easy. See you next time.
I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like